brothers and sisters in Christ, I greet you all and those that are watching this video. And before I release the prophecy God has given me about our country, I would like us to pray. Father, in the name of your Son Jesus Christ, I bow before thee to give you the glory, to give you the honor, that Lord my God, since yesterday, you have allowed me to know what is in your heart, which I'm now going to release to your children, Lord. Greatly humbled before you as I do this, as we continue to plead for your mercies. I pray this, believing and trusting in Jesus' name, our Lord and Savior. I've just taken some time before our Lord gave me a major prophecy to release. And yesterday, 9th of April, I woke up in the morning and I could tell there is something going on spiritually. I had a heavy day. At around 3:30 is when our Lord spoke to me, clearly gave me, to pass it on, Revelation 6, verse 7 and 8. This is to do with the pale horse. He also gave me Hosea 9. I thank God because, as I have repeated severally, He normally, at most of the times, gives me prophecies through His Word, which I can assure you, the Bible is living, the Word is alive. So, I urge you to read keenly those two scriptures. Catch up with what God is saying. In conclusion, He said, "Return to me and I'll return to you." This clearly tells us and shows us there is something which God has done, separating Himself to us, unless we do what He has purposed us to do. And in recognition with that, you remember, since year 2021, I have written this book, Prophetic Revelations, to guide revival movement from Africa to other nations. The good news, He's still merciful. If we can plead with Him, He can still revert about what He has planned to do. May you be blessed as you go through those scriptures. Continue to repent. Continue to plead for God's mercies. May I conclude by saying, He had clearly said, if you don't bring revival, what you are going to face is judgment. I thank God for that time He has given us. May you all be blessed. Tukutendereza Yesu.